Welcome to another edition of Fashion Counsel. Today's episode is a continuation of the interview I did with Francis Pierrel, CEO of Lacoste North America.
So I think you also mentioned Wi-Fi is also important to your customers, being able to come in and be able to have Wi-Fi in the store. So this is something different that I don't think most retailers would be expecting to provide. And so this is part of the brand lifestyle as well, right?
Well, Wi-Fi is pretty hard to get in New York City. So if you try to connect to through your mobile, usually these big buildings, they interfere. However, the way people shop, if you see somebody in a store that is playing with his phone, he's actually shopping. 40% of the people that shop in the store use their phone to help their shopping. Whether they are comparing prices, that's usually a Best Buy, or they are comparing what the offer could be somewhere else, or if I could get another color. So if you see somebody in a store using their phone, it means they are shopping. Giving them Wi-Fi is very important, so you help them shopping so they can spend their money. But at the same time, you collect information. Now think about the internet. Everything you do on the internet, we know. We know when you come, how long you spend, we call it audience, how long you spend in the shop, what product you've even looked at. In the store, we know nothing yet. But with the Wi-Fi, we will be able to, we are able now to track every movement you're doing in the store. So I can do what we call, with Tony, money mapping. So I know that wall produces more than this wall or this table. I would know, not just now, there is a little bit of a privacy, but very soon we will know who you are. Because you will let me do that, thanks to my lawyer. We will make sure that we are allowed to do this. So I will know, but for the good. So to personalize your experience to the most. So when I come, when the sales associate comes to you, she's presenting you something that you're interested in. Exactly like online. Your webpage, the webpage that, when you keep going back to Amazon, the webpage that you see is not the same one that your husband or your wife is seeing, because it's customized to the way you shop, to the way you click, to the history that you had. We want to do the same in the shops.
Yeah, big data has become a big issue for many retailers. I tell the story that I have a lot of clients and they see the future as being able to download an app for a brand, then going in the Fifth Avenue store, buying a pair of jeans, maybe they buy black jeans, and they go to Los Angeles, buy red jeans, and they go to London, buy white jeans, and they return the white jeans, and they go to Denver and buy the white jeans, and they return them. All this information is stored and gathered, and hopefully in the future, when you walk in the store, if you've downloaded the app, there's geolocation tracking and everything else, and an email will go to the manager of the store and say, Mr. Lupo's come in, very important customer, make sure you say hello, ask him how he liked his last purchase. And then when I go and pick up a pair of white jeans, a big red alert will come on my phone and say, don't buy these. Almost like a personal shopper. And so I sort of view that as the future, and I know Lacoste, especially your vision, you've been really trying to get to a point where there's an omni-channeling that all data channels sort of go to one place, and that's the goal for the future.
Yeah.
So Francis, tell me, what do you see as the biggest opportunity for growth?
It's the biggest opportunity for growth is to be where the customer wants to shop, where the customer is spending his leisure. And I see, for example, I speak with my partners in shopping malls. What they are doing, they are reinventing their shopping mall. It used to be a destination for shopping. It is a destination for entertainment. They are bringing food retailing. Italy is opening in a lot of shopping malls because it's entertaining. It's a new way to shop for your food. They are bringing luxury cinemas. They are bringing fun fair. They are bringing a Cirque du Soleil. They are doing whatever, so you have a reason to come to the mall. And while you're there, you're shopping. Well, before, the reason to come to the mall was to shop. Now, the streets of New York or the streets of the big cities, they don't do that yet because they are not merchandised. Because it's, and you were speaking about having a bank on a corner. It's definitely an obstacle to shop because it's not entertaining. I go to the bank because I need to go to the bank. And if I don't, I just pass by. And the streets of New York or the streets of the big cities in the world, they need merchandising. They need reason to come. And to buy the need to buy a polo on Fifth Avenue is not great enough to make me move and come and visit Fifth Avenue. I need something else. And even the hot dog stand can give me this.
Something that does traffic, where people actually have to come by and stop, and then they can look up and see what's going around. I understand. So last question, what are you most excited about coming down the pike for Lacoste? What are you like really excited about with the brand and where you guys are going?
Well, I would say two things. One, the brand is 80 years old, and it was for 79 years managed by the family on one side and then entrepreneurs on the other side. I was on the other side. And then the entrepreneurs, they took over. You know, that's capitalism. So we bought the company from the family, and now we are building a real brand. We have Lacoste has a new tagline. It's called "Life is a beautiful sport." So our heritage is about sport, but we want to position ourselves as a lifestyle company. So that's definitely what's on the horizon. But at the same time, from a strategic standpoint, as I mentioned, Mr. Obama before, you need to be successful in the US. So we've decided to make the US the flagship for our brand. So the flagship city of the US is New York. So I'm very excited because everything is going to happen once again in this country, not in China, not in Japan, not in India. It's happening here.
Thanks for joining us for another edition of Fashion Counsel.